Hi, I'm Shane from MN Arsenal. Today we're going to use PDQ deploy to copy files from a file server to your target computers on the all users desktop. We'll create a package right here. We'll call this one copy student tests. We're going to create a command step and delete the default install step. We're going to use xcopy. You can find the usage for xcopy by just running xcopy from a command prompt with a slash question mark, and you'll see the usage there. We're going to run xcopy slash e to copy the all directories, even if they're empty. And we're going to do I. The I means that if the directory doesn't exist in the target, it will be created as long as there's more than one file being copied. And slash y. We want the slash y because that will answer yes if any of the files in the target need to be overwritten. And we're just going to go out to our file server. I've got this path right here. I'm going to copy that. Notice that there is a space in that path, so we are going to put these in double quotes. Perfect. And then you have to place the destination. I'm going to put this in double quotes as well, even though for the most part you won't have to do that technically. But better safe than sorry. We're going to use the public variable slash desktop directory. And then we're going to create one called tests. Perfect. And this will not work on XP because XP does not have the public variable. So we're going to go into the conditions, change the OS version. Not going to run this on servers. And we're not going to run this on XP. So Vista or higher. There we go. And we'll call this one copy tests. And I'm going to duplicate this step, and we're going to create a step just for XP if you are unlucky enough to still have XP in your environment. And instead of public, we're going to use the XP variable all users profile. And of course, we're going to go back into conditions on this XP step, and we're going to remove all the workstations except for XP. So step two will only run on XP. And step one, I'm going to deploy this. There's the copy student tests. Choose targets. I'm just going to actually type these in, make it faster. We'll do this computer so you can see it get created, Quintana. And then we'll do Randy, because Randy is an XP machine. And hit deploy. It's very important to know, to remember that your deploy user, whatever user account you're using to run this deployment, it has to be able to access the network share. So there we go. Oh, you see tests was created right there. And there's the directories underneath. Now we get people saying, I'm getting error code 4 when I use xcopy. I'm going to show you how you can create that. A gotcha. First of all, as long as you verify that the path is OK. If the path's wrong, well, then all bets are off, obviously. It's not going to work. If you verify the path is OK, and use a UNC. Don't use mapped drives. If you use a mapped drive, there's some extra steps you have to do because the deploy user is not going to have those mappings available on the target computer. So just use the UNC path. And in the conditions, I'm going to actually come up with the package properties. In the run as, let's say you some people like to run their deployments as local system. The problem with that is if you run any step as a local system, it won't have access or won't be able to access remote resources, such as going out and grabbing these tests. So I've changed that. I'm going to redeploy to these computers. And you're going to see that we're going to come back with an error code 4. Why? Because the local system doesn't have access, in this case, to the token deploy share. Yep, there's error code. You can see that. Return to error code 4. You can always look at the output if you want. And you can see that it invalid drive specification. It can't access token in this case. So make sure you're not running as local system in your run as. And also make sure that whatever the deploy user is has the appropriate rights to grab the target files from the remote file system, and that will work for you. So that's how you can use Xcopy in PDQ Deploy. All right, I'm Shane. Cheers.